Well, hi everyone, and welcome to Impi, your friendly catamaran. Now, this is episode 2 of our series, Sailing Tasmania. You'll recall we had departed Promise Bay off Racinet in some fairly brisk winds.
Woo-hoo! Absolutely amazing! Lovely stuff, man!
We love being in the Southern Oceans again, and Impi just loves these waters. Now, part of our excitement is that we are sailing south for Hobart, where our daughter Jenna is flying in to see us. We stop at some islands and anchorages along the way, but I will share these with you on our northbound passage with our daughter, where we head for the Tamar River and launch system. Now, to get to Hobart sooner, we have opted to use the Dunalley Canal, also known as the Denison Canal, which some sailors have cautioned us against on account of Impi's draft and beam, so we need to do some homework on this. Right, so backing up a little bit, on our way southbound, the wind is not only building in strength, but is also changing in direction. We seek shelter off Paddy's Point in Spring Bay, not far from a town called Tribunna. There we are, our Rockner 33 kilogram anchor held well. We get no compensation for mentioning Rockner. Well, time to get down to Dunalley Canal. We need to get through to Hobart. But before we do, and maybe this is a good time to mention this, I was wondering if I should share this or not, but for sailors maybe going here, they'd find it interesting. So at this point, it may be worth mentioning that we had spent some time at anchor before sailing south, planning our passage through the Denison Canal, or Dunelly, whichever you prefer to call it, I guess. Now, wherever there are narrows to entrances from open seas, and in this case to a rather shallow but large bay, Black Man Bay, we need to understand how tides and currents interact with wind and the timing of current flows at the various locations if entering and exiting in one go. For example, here at the Marion Narrows, high water is approximately the same time as at Hobart. But at the Denison Canal, the ebb stream, that is from high to low, flows in a southwesterly direction through the canal, and it starts at around 2.5 hours after high water Hobart.
With most narrow entrances, including the Marion Narrows, we want to be entering where possible in the last hour of a flooding tide. And of course we consider local conditions and how this influences the timing of slack water.
Folks, just for those who don't know, a slack water, this is the short period when water is completely unstressed and without movement in any direction in the tidal stream. Now, as a rule of thumb, it occurs on the change of tide, but more accurately, it occurs when, with all other influences, the tidal stream pauses to reverse in direction.
We want to time our entry as best possible to proceed all the way through in favorable conditions. Locals tell us that currents can be particularly strong in the Marion Narrows, making it challenging, especially for sailors entering for the first time. However, our planning paid off and we found calm conditions, and the maritime folks of Tasmania had really marked the channel well. One needs to be mindful of the fact that the main tidal stream runs in and out of both ends of Blackman Bay, And usually from the bridge of the Denison Canal, the flood stream flows in a northeasterly direction, beginning roughly 2.5 hours after low water in Hobart. The ebb stream flows southwest through the canal, beginning roughly 2.25 hours after high water in Hobart.
Because Blackman Bay is shallow, easterly winds can build up the water, and this can have influence on current flow, speed and strength, as well as the timing of current flow in and around the canal, so we need to be mindful of this. We are advised by locals that an ebb tide combined with strong easterly winds can have the effect of currents racing through the canal at around 10 knots and resulting in heavy overfalls. Strong southwesterly winds can have the opposite effect, but usually not as dramatic.
Due to the way currents respond to tides at the canal itself, we are advised to be prepared to anchor somewhere in Blackman Bay and wait for the opportunity to pass through. Anchoring in Blackman Bay is not great on account of duckweed grass on the seabed, and sometimes the mast moorings, that is Maritime and Safety Tasmania courtesy moorings, may be occupied, which makes it all the more worth timing one's passage through here very well.
We need to beat a westerly weather system predicted for later in the day. At the same time, we plan to be at the entrance to the Marion Narrows just 1/2 hour before high water there. Cross the approximate 5 nautical mile distance over Blackman Bay, which is roughly 1 hour. This means we would arrive at the Denison Canal 1/2 hour after high water in Hobart, and therefore on the last 2 hours of a flooding tide at the canal, which is great. So here we are, we're in Marion Bay, and we're heading for Marion Narrows. It's a sandbar crossing at Marion Narrows, and something the locals tell us to be cautious of. However, there is a buoy that marks the entry position, apparently, and one sort of eyeballs it from there. Right now, usually we would be looking for a safe watermark indicating the end of a channel and deep water ahead for vessels coming in the opposite direction and leaving the channel. However, the first marker or buoy that we found was a port lateral marker, which is fine, but had us approach at a narrower angle and closer to the mark. We can't complain. Australia has a terrific marking system. Now, Australia operates on the IALA System A, I-A-L-A System A. That's the International Association of Lighthouse Authorities System A. Now, on System A, a vessel heading into harbour from open sea or up a channel or river toward its source keeps the red marker to port.
Hey, listen, man, you want me to drive, you know?
No, hey, man, I'm cool. Tell you what, man, I'll only go 5 miles an hour, okay? We won't attract attention.
We were first made aware of the Denison Canal by a Tasmanian we met on mainland Australia. He told us that you needed to have a six-pack of beer, which you placed in a net to have the bridge lifted. Nowadays, however, this is no longer permitted, as there were supposedly too many accidents. Well, I'm not sure if all this is true, but what we do know is that the bridge opens from 8 in the morning till 5 in the afternoon. You need to contact the operator one day in advance to book a passage and then confirm your expected arrival at the bridge 1 hour in advance. Our operator was super nice, even without a six-pack of beer. The Denison Canal was completed in 1905 under the direction of Governor Denison after some 50 years of pressure from the settlers, who wanted a safer seaway to Hobart. Indeed, often there are rough and hazardous conditions around Cape Raoul, which needs to be contoured to get to the Derwent and into Hobart. The canal meanders for just under 1 kilometre through shifting sandbanks, recorded at the lowest point as 1.7 metres. but on the whole between 2.6 and 3.9 meters deep. Enough for a catamaran, but some boats may need to go in at high tide.
Well, our plan was to sail directly for Hobart and be there a week or so before the arrival of our daughter Jenna. However, remember those westerly winds that we spoke of? Well, they arrived with such gusto, we had no time to film the situation. We had our hands full, and we were turned off course for our fallback position, which is to discover a suitable anchorage in Norfolk Bay by dropping south. Climbing over the Alston wall, I'm bound for the riverside. Well, I go to the river to soothe my mind, ponder over the crazy.
Taranna was a great choice to wait out the westerlies, and wait them out we did for almost a week. It is safe in all winds, except for the fiercest northerlies, and the anchor holding is fantastic. Taranna is part of the Tasman Peninsula, almost separated from Forestier Peninsula by Eagle's Hawk Bay, except for a narrow strip of land at Eagle's Hawk Neck, where history pricks the mind into recalling the days of what was known as the Dogland. Since Tasman Peninsula is a historic prison site, to prevent prisoners escaping, dogs were tied at sufficient intervals spanning the narrow isthmus, and dogs barking would alert the guards to movement in the bush. Who let the dogs out?
Right, so back at the anchorage, a short dinghy ride to land will see one arrive at the historic Norfolk Bay convict station.
A little bit nippy here.
Yeah, I had to wear my coffee bag.
You're wearing your little coffee bag thing?
Yeah. I think this house has got something to do with the convicts, and I thought there would be some information there, but it's all about Norfolk Bay. It's from the 19th century.
Oh, it's a beautiful old house. Look at this.
Yeah.
Well, this house, Norfolk Bay Convict Station, was built in 1838 as Australia's first railway station, since ships bound for the prison grounds at Port Arthur had to otherwise face a dangerous journey across Storm Bay, rounding Cape Raoul. So passengers and goods were unloaded instead in Norfolk Bay and loaded into rail carts, which were pushed by prisoners the 8 kilometre distance across land, where they were unloaded and rowed for Port Arthur. Port Arthur is a spectacular visit, especially being anchored off the historic site in the bay. We visit this on our northbound journey with our daughter Jenna. Okay, so back at Taranna, we have now arrived at this historic house. We're going to take a walk, we don't have a motor car, for what locals tell us is a must-do event, and that is to eat scallop pie at a little restaurant called Fish Lips.
What are we having here?
We are having some scallop pie.
Scallop pies? This is the first scallop pie?
This is a Tasmanian speciality.
Yeah?
Scallop
pies or Tasmanian specialities?
I took a walk around the world, eased my troubled mind. I left my body lying somewhere in the sands of time.
Hasn't this been an awesome place?
I really love it.
This is very cool. Thanks for having us here.
It's been so wonderful
to
have
you here.
So
this is Nina?
This
is Nina?
Yes.
Hi,
Nina. Hello.
Very cool.
Enjoy your adventures.
Oh, it was so nice. We enjoyed the scallop pies and we enjoyed chatting to Mum as well. Mum's an awesome person. She's gone to do some cooking.
And all these amazing wines from Tasmania.
And I've actually just been told exactly where these wines all come from.
Yeah, because it's Norfolk Bay.
Well,
so
it's right across the way over here. And then this one is closer to Hobart, apparently, the Bream Creek.
Okay.
Very nice. So we're drinking very local wine.
I know, and it's amazing. Will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive and well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you by my side with my superhuman light, kryptonite.
Yeah. Oh, we had to catch Mum a little bit. Thanks very much for having us here.
Oh,
Lovely to have you.
Yeah, you're
lovely
an awesome cook. We had a great time with you.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much.
You are amazing people.
Thank you.
See you again.
You will see us again. We'll definitely be here again. And so should you. Thank you. You stumble in and bump your head. If not for me, then you'd be dead. I pick you up and put you back on solid ground. If I go crazy, then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive and well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you by my side with my superhuman might, kryptonite. Crazy, then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive and well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you by my side with my superhuman might, kryptonite. Walking with shopping again. If I'm crazy, then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive. This is the not so fun part for me. But Anna likes it. She says it keeps me in shape, keeps my stomach down.
Because I just eat and do nothing, right?
There's some comments coming from the peanut gallery at the back there.
Just eat and do nothing.
Anna says I usually eat and do nothing, so she likes me to carry a lot of shopping and she overloads me. She thinks I'm still sort of in my 20s. I do have that sort of look, right? Crazy, then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive, well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you. What have you bought yourself there?
I'm going to go fishing.
You're going to go fishing?
Yeah.
What are we going to catch?
There's two here. You got flatheads, which are ugly brown fish.
Yeah.
But they're really nice, like battered.
Okay.
And then you got whitings.
Flatheads, whitings.
Yeah, which normally the people make crumbs.
Very cool, flatheaded and whiting. We're going to catch these things. Then will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive and well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you by my side with my superhuman might, kryptonite. Call me strong, you keep you by my side with my superhuman might, kryptonite.